Hi, this is Els from Els Vandenberg Studio for Elizabeth Craft Designs. In this YouTube, I'm going to show you a technique with the glitter, making an imprint in the tape using your die. So what I did first, I took the clear double-sided adhesive and adhered it to the soft finish cardstock, the 85 LB, 230 grams. So you adhere it to the cardstock. Let me move this out of the way. And let me show you this before we start. The background of this card, that's a paper, that's this one, that's from Through the Lens, the Wood series. So that's what I use for the background paper. I'm very excited about that because I took all those pictures myself. Just exciting. So here I have the two pieces. So let me show you. So these are the two pieces of the white cardstock with the double-sided adhesive on top. So what I'm going to do in this case, I'm going to take off one layer of the release sheet and then I'm going to take the second piece. So I'm going to make a double layer of cardstock, which makes it heavier, and I'm going to trim it later. So I'm going to try to line it up as beautiful, as good as possible, but I'm going to trim off the sides later. So now I have a thick layer of cardstock with the clear double-sided adhesive on top. So what I did then, I take my die and I'm going to run it through my Big Shot or any die cutting machine, Cuttlebuck, Spellbinders, doesn't matter, any machine that takes the wafer thin dies, and you're going to run it through your machine. And then what it does, and that's what I did here, so you run this through your machine, and what it does, it makes an imprint in the top layer. I don't know if you can see it now, but it will show later for sure. It makes an imprint in the tape, but because it's thicker, it doesn't cut through, and that's what I want. So I don't want the die to cut all the way through. So that's what I have here. So now I can start working on the technique. So I'm going to take my glitter tray, and here again, coffee filter, Swiffer, that's my tool to use, brush, spoon, and for this technique, very important, the fine pointed tweezer. So I'm going to make the black outline first. You're going to work from dark to light. So I'm going to take out the release sheet. So I'm only going to lift up the release sheet that makes the black line. So I'm just using my fine pointed tweezer and I'm taking this out carefully because you can actually use this as a stencil for another technique as well. You see, so you want to save this. So now everything that's sticky now, that's where the black will be. So I'm going to take my black, and I can use my metal spoon and I can just sprinkle a little bit like that and then just start polishing it in. There's different techniques to do that. You can just sprinkle it, and because it's all going to go back into the jar, and polish it really well. And then with the next colors, I'm going to brush it off first, but because this is the first color, I can just polish it before I brush it off. Okay, then I'm going to take my brush and I'm going to brush this off really well. So make sure everything is gone, and the last part that sticks to the tape, I'm just going to remove using my Swiffer. So because I'm using a coffee filter, I can easily pour it back into the jar. And as a trash can, I'm using a paper bag, because a paper bag is not static, so it's very easy to remove the last glitter from my coffee filter. So that's the black. And again, I want to make sure this is clean so I can polish it a little bit more. And then I'm going to take my Swiffer and you can just take off the last little bit of that black glitter. Make sure the back is clean as well before I go to the next color. And as you can see, so now the whole outline is black. And you need to polish, because if you don't polish, that next color will stick to the black, and you don't want that. So now I can just start picking up the pieces, and as you can see in the sample, I can use as many colors as I want, and you can see how easy it is using that fine pointed tweezer to take out those pieces. And because we don't, let me take out the pieces first, and I can do one flower in red, I can also do two flowers. Let me do in this case. So for the sample, I used five different colors, but you can use as many colors as you want, of course. One thing that's very important is that your diamond, so I used on the outside, I used the warm diamond here, that will always be your last color. So you try to go from dark to light, but very important, diamond or white will always be your last color. So I have my red here, so I just sprinkle a little bit. And in this case, I'm going to brush it off a little bit here. The rest goes there. See, now I'm going to brush it off. And because I polished that black, you will see that red will not stick to the black anymore. So brush it off. I'm going to put this back into the jar. And then I'm going to polish. And again, clean it off the coffee filter. And then I'm just, a little bit too much. And then I'm going to, and that's why I have my Swiffer here. If I spill something, it's going to stick to the Swiffer. And now I'm going to polish this one. You see, so now I have the red. And now I'm going to take my Swiffer again and clean this up. You see, so now I have my red. And then I can go on to the next color. If I have, see a little bit of red here, I just use my Swiffer to clean that off as well. And then I will do a second color. Let's do, they're all beautiful colors. This is the saffron. It's a really nice color as well. So same technique. So you just keep, and as you can see here, that will show right away. I forgot to take a piece off of the liner. There you go. So take this off. And again, put it back. And if you have like, this is just a lid that I'm using, like a cardboard lid. And I have my Swiffer in there. Like a wooden tray works really well. So you cover your wooden tray with Swiffers. Just your Swiffer is your magic tool in this one as well. Oh. There we go. And then polish this one. And then again, clean this off using my Swiffer. And as you can see, I can go on and on with different colors. So I will just, and then I will make the centers. In this case, I will make the centers diamond as well. Oh, I have some glitter on my hands. Of course, Swiffer for that as well. So I'm just going to do those last two flowers in the same color. So you can see this, it's a great technique. So any dye that you can use to make an imprint, could be a beautiful butterfly, could be flowers, can be, we have the cupcake dye, the shells will work really nice for this technique as well. So those are from Josette Designs, also Elizabeth Craft Designs, of course. Like the poinsettia for Christmas. Okay, so last color. Let's do that in the copper. Oh no, let's do the rust. So I'm taking the rust for these. And again, you can use as much colors as you want to, of course. You can make them daisies, so all white, or brush it off again really well. And then in this case, I will do the centers in diamond as well, just to speed up the process a little bit. Because you get the technique. So it's very easy. You can make it as colorful as you want to. Okay. Take this off. Polish this. So now I'm going to do the rest in the diamond. And because it's a diamond, it's a transparent, you need to make sure that everything is really clean. And then I'm just going to take out the centers, and then I need to take off all those pieces that are in between here, of course. And see that I don't forget anything. So all those in between pieces, and you can do those in a different color if you want to, that's all up to you. You can make it as colorful as you want to. All those pieces in between. Almost goes there. And you can see like the fine pointed tweezer is really handy for this technique. And now I can just start anywhere. I can just tear this. Take this away. One little piece here. And one little piece here. So now everything is exposed. So now I can take my warm diamond. And just sprinkle it. And when I use the diamond a lot of times, because I don't want any specks of color in there, I kind of tap it off. But then I like to put this back into the jar first and then brush it off. Because if you have any specks, if you didn't polish really well, you might see some color in your diamond and you don't want that. So just clean it up first and then I'm going to brush it. You see, because there's still diamond on here. So then I'm going to brush it off. And there's so little that's coming off. And that's to save your diamond from getting any color of that in there. Oh, it's here. Clean this up. And then I'm just going to polish this one. And then this is ready. So then you can use this on the card. Thank you for watching. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.